Hello, I welcome all the students for the lecture series of subject Theory of Computation. Under unit number 2, that is regular expression, we have seen how to construct the regular expression from the given language L. In the last lecture, we have seen a few examples on construction of regular language from the given language L. Now, today, what we will discuss, how to find the language from the regular expression R, means construction of language from the regular expression, that is vice versa. In the past few lectures, we have seen how to construct the regular expression from the given language L. Now, we will construct the language L from the given regular expression. Now, here there is a regular expression, you are given with regular expression R is equals to A plus B star dot B. Now, what will be the language for the given regular expression R? A plus B closure concatenation B dot B. So, first of all, what we need to do, if we need to construct the language, what is language? Language is a set of strings. So, first of all, we need to find out all possible strings which are derived with the help of given regular expression. So, L is equals to all possible strings. So, first of all, I will consider this as epsilon and I will write only B. Then I will say A B, I will say B B, one occurrences of B must be there, okay. That is this B. I will consider out of this A and B, I will consider B. One B and ending with what? B. Then I will say AAB, I will say ABB, I will say BBB and so on. What does it mean? If you look at the strings which are generated with the help of given regular expression, you can note here one B is there, this B must be there. This B must be there, B must be there, B must be there. Here it clearly indicates that the string must be end with what? B. String must be end with B. And before that B, any number of A's and B's are allowed. Any number of A's or B's are allowed. So, that string must end with what? B. So, accordingly we can write the language. Accordingly, we can write the language L, the set of all string set of all strings over alphabet A comma B or alphabet A comma B ending with B. This is the language. This is the language. We can say set of all strings over summation is equals to A comma B ending with B. So, that is one of the construction of language from the given regular expression. We will see one more example. Regular expression R is equals to A plus B closure concatenation B A. Construct the language L from the given regular expression. As far as language is concerned, set of all strings which are possible with the help of given regular expression, it is BA. I will consider one A from this and BA, I will consider one B from this and BA, I will consider both AB and ABA ends with BA, I will consider AAA ends with BA and so on and so on. So, what you identify here, you can identify here that whatever the strings are there, possible strings which are derived with the help of given regular expression are, in those particular string it ends with BA. The given string ends with what? BA. And before that BA, any number of A's and B's are allowed. So language L you can represent as the set of all strings or summation is equals to A comma B ending with BA. Here we can represent comma. So all the strings ends with what? BA. So that is what the construction of what? Regular expression. We will see one more example. That is construction of language from the given regular expression. If we are having a regular expression R is equals to A alteration B closure dot A alteration B closure dot A alteration B closure. What is the language L? So the language L for the given regular expression, first of all we need to represent, we need to derive all possible strings with the help of given regular expression. It generates, like, first of all I will say epsilon for this A, again epsilon for this, followed by A, again epsilon, that means double A. I'll say B, A, I'll say this as epsilon, A, epsilon. Then I'll consider A, or I'll say B, this A mandatory, again this B, this A mandatory, again this B. After this I'll say A, then I'll say this A, epsilon and A. I'll say B, A, B and so on. So if you look at the regular expression and the strings which are generated or derived with the help of that regular expression, you can note that in all the strings, whatever the strings which are derived with the help of given regular expression, in those all strings at least 2A should be present. So from that we can write the language L is equals to the set of all strings over alphabet summation is equals to A comma B comma contains at least 2A's. And we can also represent this in the form of L of R, that is language of regular expression. L of R is equals to language over summation is equals to A comma B containing at least 2A's. So like this way we can construct the language L for the given regular expression. So I'll stop here. In the next lecture we will see how to convert the given regular expression into finite automata, or how to find the finite automata from the given regular expression. That we will see in the next lecture. Thank you.